next?
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Members, welcome home.
Thank you. It feels good to be home. I miss you. For the record, my name is Sarah Gelser. I'm the state senator from Senate District 8, which includes Corvallis, Albany, Philomath, Tangent, Millersburg, and unincorporated areas of Lynn and Benton County and Philomath. I'm very pleased to be here today in support of House Bill 2234. And my purpose for sitting before you is to take you back in time a little bit to remind you of what this bill is about, why these assessments are so important, and why they are medically necessary and appropriately covered by medical insurance and the Oregon Health Plan. In 2005, there was a tragic situation in my community. A beautiful little girl named Carly Sheehan died. She died after she was tortured and abused by her mother's boyfriend. What made this death even more tragic was that she had been referred to child welfare three times in the year leading up to her death, and those incidents were unsubstantiated. With apologies to Sandy, because I'm still learning the technology over on the Senate side in terms of how our printer works. So I brought some photographs to tell you the story of why these assessments save lives. Remember that Carly died in June. In December of that year, Carly was with her dad and was making visits.
Remember the prior year.
In December of 2004, David Sheehan, who gave me permission to use these photos today, I spoke with him this morning, prepared Carly to go for the weekend to visit her mother. You have up there this photograph of Carly on Friday afternoon.
It's coming.
Yes. Okay, it will
we
be coming.
We didn't have enough.
So there's this photograph of Carly, and what I like to notice about this photograph that's so very important is her beautiful hair. She has a lot of beautiful blonde hair. Before Carly came home at the end of the weekend, David got a phone call that said, Carly isn't feeling very well. She doesn't look so good. This is what Carly looked like when she came back at the end of the weekend. You'll see she didn't want to let go of her dad. You'll see she's missing a lot of that beautiful hair that she had just days before. And her body and her head was completely covered with these bruises. They're devastating photos. David was terrified and worried. He called the police. He called the child welfare worker who had previously done an abuse investigation, and he called his neighbor who was a nurse. Law enforcement officer came out, went and talked to the mom and the boyfriend, and they said she did it to herself. The law enforcement officer said that seemed consistent with the story. They called the DHS child welfare worker, and they said that it could wait until Monday. The nurse said, you need to take pictures of this. On Monday, when David still didn't get a call back, he physically took Carly to the child welfare office along with these photographs. Those photographs were then lost and never seen again until the trial for her murder. Carly did not have the benefit of a child abuse medical examination. At the trial, Dr. Carol Shervinek, who is the medical director of ABC House in Albany, testified that had she seen this child, she could have told you in that very first moment that this was a child that was a victim of child abuse, that a two-year-old, she's 2 years old in this picture, a two-year-old cannot inflict that type of self-injury on herself. If Carly had the benefit of a child abuse medical assessment in December of 2004, she would have turned 13 last month. And many of us in Corvallis ate cookies that were purchased at a downtown bakery, also in Portland and in Dublin, Ireland, to celebrate her birthday. But we didn't have those child abuse medical assessments. So after her killer was convicted, we introduced House Bill, ironically, 3324. Now we're at House Bill 2234, that required child abuse medical assessments whenever there is a case of a suspicious physical injury. We very clearly defined what a suspicious physical injury is. And just to remind you, so you know what we are asking these plans to cover, suspicious physical injuries include, but are not limited to, burns or scalds, excessive bruising, bruising or abrasions on any part of the body, bruising, swelling, or abrasions on the head, neck, or face, fractures of any bone in a child under the age of 3, multiple fractures in a child of any age, dislocation, soft tissue swelling, or moderate to severe cuts, loss of the ability to walk or move normally according to the child's developmental ability, unconsciousness or difficulty maintaining consciousness, multiple injuries of different types, injuries causing serious or protracted disfigurement or loss of impairment of the function of any bodily organ, and any other injury that threatens the physical well-being of the child. Just like Carly, we are talking about a very serious situation that requires medical attention and would be appropriately covered by medical insurance. The burden to our extraordinary child abuse assessment centers has been enormous in carrying out the work that has been required by this law. In the first year after Carly's law went into effect, the number of child abuse medical assessments increased by over 175%. Carly's law did not cause a whole bunch of children to become injured. What Carly's law did was shine a spotlight on all of the kids that we were missing that have fallen through the cracks. And what the assessment centers have told me, and district attorneys and child welfare workers, is that Carly's law has saved lives of Oregon children. Other states are now looking at implementing this law and municipalities, and it's going to have a positive impact in other places as well. And I like to think that that is Carly's legacy, because her father has been so willing to be so open about what happened to Carly. In order to continue this work, we have to be able to pay for these assessments. To me, it only makes sense that the Oregon Health Authority and our private insurers would cover these exams. These are medically necessary, they save lives, and helping kids like Carly, responding and making sure that when you come home from a weekend and you look like this, you have access to a doctor that has the expertise to be able to help you with both your physical, emotional, and family needs. It isn't just a medical necessity, it's a moral imperative. I hope that you'll join me in supporting House Bill 2234. It's critically important, and you can know it's something we can do today to keep kids safe and help these centers do the extraordinary work that they do every day for truly the most vulnerable children in our state. Thank you, Mr. Chair.